Hey everyone, so today I wanted to talk about this fun way to think up new story ideas and to kind of get your brain flowing when you're trying to think about a new story. And this is called flip the premise. Basically the idea is that you take a story that already exists and then you make the antagonists the protagonists and the protagonists the antagonists, or the bad guys the good guys and the good guys the bad guys, however you want to look at it. And essentially you take the antagonist and you make them sympathetic, and then you take the good guys and whatever element and you make them evil or darker or more twisted. And so when you do this, you create an entirely new story. So let me give you an example. So in a city, there is a mass vigilante who is oppressing the people. He believes that he is the symbol of rule of law. He believes that he is the symbol of morality, and that he sets the morality for these people. Anyone who defies him, he gets out of his way. And so he essentially runs this city like a tyrant. Even the police turn a blind eye because they are afraid of him. They're not exactly sure who he is, and sometimes some of them help him, but most of the time they try to stay away from him because they're afraid of what he might do to them and their families. But then one day, one of the citizens decides enough is enough. He decides that this is not the way that we should live, that we should be able to live freely, that we should be able to choose what we are going to do, that human beings have to decide what systems of morality they will individually believe and rely upon, not this tyrannical vigilante who is oppressing them. And so he decides to come out and face this vigilante and try to kill him once and for all. And so the vigilante attacks back and turns the city against this man and tells the city that this man will descend the city into chaos if he is allowed to continue this ideology. And so what we have here is the foundations for a Batman versus Joker story, where Joker, in a sense, is the protagonist and Batman is the antagonist, or where the ideas behind the two characters are flipped, where Batman's desire for the rule of law and justice and morality is turned and shifted and made darker, and Joker's more chaotic ideas are made more sympathetic and under the guise of freedom and this sort of thing. And so you don't necessarily take the actual story itself, but you take the concepts behind that story and then you create an entirely new story with those concepts. And what's also interesting with this is you can use scenes from that original story as guidelines and as inspiration to help you build this new story. When you change the perspective, then you're able to create a more interesting story. This is useful because it gets you thinking in a way where you are deconstructing stories and adding your own ideas to them to create something unique. So here's another idea. In a desolate post-apocalyptic world, a man has found an oasis, and he has this village of people that he keeps at this oasis, and he watches over them and protects them, and there are thieves and murderers and all these other groups around, but he has been able to keep his people safe and in relative peace. But he's getting old, and he's worried that when he dies, everything will just descend into chaos. But there is a little glimmer of hope. Finally, after trying for so long, his wife is pregnant. Now this child can be his heir. And as this child grows up, he can teach this child how to watch over these people, how to keep them safe, and how to fight against outsiders. But then one day, while he's out hunting, thieves come in and kidnap his pregnant wife and take her away. And so his glimmer of hope, the thing that is going to be his legacy, has now been taken. And so this is the setup for Immortan Joe from Mad Max Fury Road being the hero of the story. And so as you can see, when you flip the story, you can make everyone, you can make any character sympathetic, and you can make any other character non-sympathetic or antagonistic. It really is all about your point of view and just shifting characters a little bit here and there to make them more or less sympathetic. This is also useful because it can help you make more gray characters. A lot of times we can get in situations where we're writing very black and white characters, where these people are obviously the good guys and these people are obviously the bad guys. But that's not necessarily how human beings work, and so it makes a lot And so it makes your story a lot more interesting when you actually have characters with flaws and good things about them and terrible things about them, and they must reconcile those different things within them in your story. And so when you actually start with a villain who now you have to turn into a hero, or a hero you now have to turn into a villain, you can see the characters in different lights, and that can help you make a more gray character. Here's one more example. A prison warden is watching over his prison, and he's doing his best to rehabilitate the prisoners inside and give them anything they need to, you know, become better and become productive members of society when they actually leave. One day, a new prisoner comes in who is different from everyone else. He's very personable, he's very professional, he has manners, he doesn't seem to be like the average prisoner. And so the warden takes a liking to him, and the prisoner asks for different things, like he asks to build a library, he asks to have classes for the prisoners, he asks for music to be played about the prison, these sorts of things. And the warden accepts because he's like, great, this guy is helping me create the best environment within this prison to help these inmates actually become productive members of society. Until one day, after years and years and years, that prisoner escapes and he embezzles all this money out of the prison. He swipes the warden clean and he disappears to Mexico. And this character had been manipulating everyone the entire time. He was completely guilty of the crimes that he committed, and he was doing nothing but manipulating everyone around him until he could get what he wanted, which was to escape the prison. And so that is an example of Shawshank Redemption with Andy Dufresne and the warden, and flipping those characters. And so you can make this as specific or as general as you want to. And the more specific that you get, the more interesting I think it becomes, because then you can look at different scenes and plot points and how those would be different if, you know, you actually flip the antagonist and the protagonist. And so it's easiest to do this with stories that have clear protagonists and antagonists that are people. Obviously, it's harder to do it if, you know, the antagonist is nature. And something like The Martian, for example, a movie I've talked about a pretty good amount on this channel, it's harder to do that because nature is not a person. But there are still things you can do. So like, for example, in that movie, maybe you can make it about how humanity is harming nature and we consume without ever giving back or creating anything sustainable. You also maybe could do something with maybe the crew that was with Mark Watney, the main character in the movie, maybe they left him for dead on the planet for some reason. And then you could ask, well, why? And then maybe you could go, okay, well, maybe NASA is this corrupt organization for some reason. And for some reason, Mark Watney found something out and then they left him for dead there. And so you can actually still use this to get ideas flowing and to get your mind working on creating a new story. And so I think it's a very, very interesting tool. It's great for the brainstorming process. It's great if you feel really stuck on an idea. It's also great if you have a story that is sort of similar to yours in certain ways. And maybe you can say, okay, well, what sort of beats, what sort of ideas do they use in this story over here that I can then take and change and morph and then make it my own in the story that I'm working on. So I hope that was helpful. And again, down in the comments below, I want you to do this. Flip the premise on a movie that you like and give us the new summary of the plot, and let's see if we can guess what that movie is. If you like the video, please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.